I'm excited about electric cars, and they're one of the solutions to climate change. And I want to help to clear some doubts that potential electric vehicle buyers might have. If you start to drive an electric car, there might be a lot of questions that will arise in the first months regarding the ranges that you can achieve and the energy consumption of your car in general. For example, how much energy did your last rides consume? How much energy can you gain through regenerative braking? How will your battery degrade over the years? How much energy do you lose when you park your car in the garage overnight while it's not charging? In this video, I want to show you how you can answer these questions for yourself. So first of all, I want to show you how you can answer these questions with a service like Teslametric. And afterwards, I want to show you how you can get your hands on the raw data yourself. I quickly want to mention that I initiated this video and I'm not sponsored by Teslametric. Now let's get started by looking at Albert's Tesla Model S historic data from 2019 in Teslametric. This chart visualizes all energy flows. As we can see, Albert charged a third of the energy at home, almost two-thirds at regular charging stations, and only 4% at superchargers. 80% of the energy was used for driving, and 20% was lost during the times the car was parked. By looking at the lost energy while your car was parking, also referred to as phantom drain or here as vampire drain, you can monitor how much a feature like sentry mode drains the car's battery. This might help you to weigh up the pros and cons of such a feature and decide when it is worth turning on and when saving battery is your priority. You can see this information for every parking event. What I also find interesting is the fact that the energy recovered through regenerative braking is almost exactly the same as the energy lost during parking. Both account to around 700 kilowatt hours in 2019. So in his case, regenerative braking kind of equals out the standby losses. The consumption efficiency is calculated by the actual trip distance divided by the lost estimated range. So if your estimated range is 500 kilometers and you drive 50 kilometers, your range should be 450 kilometers, right? However, if you drove very inefficiently, for example at a high velocity, your new estimated range might be 430 kilometers, so 20 kilometers less. This would lead to an efficiency level of around 71%. In Albert's case, his average efficiency level of last year was 80%. You can also have a look at the energy consumption of individual trips and see their tracks visualized. Orange sections of a track show that energy was consumed, and green sections show that energy was gained through regenerative braking. You can also see the speed and energy consumption for each moment. So how about charging costs? If you once enter the tariffs from the charging stations you use, it can automatically calculate the charging costs. I think this is a great feature, at least in Germany, where the cost structures of charging providers are not very easy to compare in your mind. For a petrol car, you only need to compare petrol prices per liter. But for charging stations, without simplifying it with your data, you need to compare minute prices to kilowatt hour prices to monthly fees. So what about battery degradation? You can access the estimated battery capacity of your own Tesla. By keeping track of it, you can compare your degradation to the expected degradation. I will link some sources of what degradation you should expect in the video description. Albert told me that one of his customers monitored his degradation and realized it was degrading too fast. He then went to a Tesla service center and got his battery replaced. How cool is that? You can also ask the service center to tell you the battery health, but monitoring it yourself seems much more convenient to me. So at this point, thanks to Albert for giving me access to his Tesla's data. So now I have shown you some features of Teslametric. But how does it work though? And how can you pull data yourself? Every Tesla is connected to the internet and continuously sends data to Tesla's own servers, as long as network coverage is available or the car is connected through Wi-Fi. Now, some of the data that a Tesla produces can be accessed through an API. I will link API documentation down below. You can access this API with token-based authentication. It means you generate a token, a kind of a very strong password and key which can be used to authorize access to the data. After you generated a token, you won't need your Tesla username and password from this point on to access the data. If you gave a token to someone to do some data analysis for you and you want to revoke the access, simply change your Tesla.com password. This will invalidate all tokens immediately. So after you have created a token, you can now start to pull data from a Tesla remotely. You can receive real-time information regarding the car's GPS location, energy consumption, current speed, battery recuperation, state of charge, and much more. So how often should you pull the data? Teslametric pulls data every 5 seconds while you drive, and every 40 seconds while the car is parked. By continuously pulling such information, you can create a history of your rides and charges and start to monitor your car's behavior. I hope this was helpful to you. If you want to see the full interview and learn about the backstory of Teslametric, have a look, I linked it in the video description below. So what would you do with the data, or which kind of information would you like to have access to? Dear Tesla, if you're listening, I would love to have access to autopilot information. Then we could all see how many percent of the rides were driven by ourselves and how many percent were driven by autopilot. And then we could see over software updates how this would increase over time. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye.